Assalamu alaikum students. Over the past few lectures, we have been discussing the topology of metric spaces. In the last lecture, we studied the definition of an open set in a metric space. We had a look at some example theorems on open sets. For example, an open sphere or an open ball in a metric space is an open set. Empty set is an open subset of every metric space. Every metric space is an open subset of itself. A finite intersection of open subsets of a metric space is an open set. And an arbitrary union of open subsets of a metric space is an open set. So we had a look at all these theorems in the last lecture, but we didn't prove these theorems. So from now on, we are going to prove these theorems one by one. So in today's lecture, we are going to prove that an open sphere or an open ball in a metric space is an open set. Okay. So the theorem for today's lecture is, an open sphere or an open ball in a metric space is an open set. Okay, so we are going to prove this theorem. So from the definition of an open set, we know that a set is said to be an open set in a metric space if an open sphere around each point or element of that set lies entirely in the set. Okay. So in order to prove that an open sphere in a metric space is an open set, so we are going to consider an open sphere which is in the form of this circle with the center A and radius R, which is SRA. Okay, so we are considering this open sphere in a metric space, and we have to prove that this open sphere SRA is an open set. So according to the definition of an open set, we will show that if we consider any element x inside this open sphere, and if we draw another open sphere around that point, and if this open sphere lies entirely in this open sphere, then this open sphere SRA will be an open set. So we are considering an open sphere around the element x of SRA. So let us call the radius of this open sphere is R1. So this is SR1x. Okay. So we are considering an open sphere SRX inside SRA. So in order to prove that SRA is an open set, we will show that SR1x is a subset of SRA. So this is how we are going to prove this theorem. Okay, so let SRA be an open sphere in a metric space XT. Okay. Then SRA will be an open set if there exists a positive real number R1 such that for any element X belonging to SRA, the open sphere with radius R1 centered at X lies entirely in SRA. Okay, so we have to show this. So we have to prove this in order to prove this theorem. Okay, so now in order to prove that SR1X is a subset of SRA, so we will choose any point Y inside SR1X and we will show that this point also belongs to SRA. Okay, so let Y be an element of SR1X, then we show that Y is also an element of SRA. Okay, so if we take any arbitrary element Y inside SR1X and if that element also belongs to SRA, then it will be proved that SR1X is a subset of SRA, and eventually this will prove that SRA is an open set. Okay, so now Y belongs to SR1X. So this thing implies that the distance between X and Y is less than R1. So this is from the definition of an open sphere. Okay, so if an element Y belongs to this open sphere SR1X, then according to the definition of an open sphere, the distance between X and Y will be less than R1. And Y belongs to SRA, so this thing implies that the distance between A and Y is less than R. So again, from the definition of an open sphere. Okay, so from this thing, that distance between X and Y is less than R1, we are going to show that the distance between A and Y is less than R. So we can write that the distance between A and Y is less than or equal to the distance between A and X plus the distance between X and Y. So from the triangular inequality. So this is triangular inequality. Okay, so from triangular inequality, we can write that the distance between A and Y is less than or equal to the distance between A and X plus the distance from X to Y. So we can further write it as, so distance between A and Y is less than, so now what is the distance between A and X? So here what is this distance? So this distance here is basically R minus R1. So D of AY is less than R minus R1 and plus D of XY, and D of XY is less than R1. So here it will be R1. So this implies D of AY is less than R, so which implies that Y belongs to SRA. Okay, So an element y belonging to SR1x also belongs to SRA. So this implies SR1x is a subset of SRA, so which implies SRA is an open set. Okay, which brings us to the proof of our theorem. Okay, so with this we come to the end of today's lecture. In today's lecture we proved that an open sphere or an open ball in a metric space is an open set. In the next lecture we will prove that empty set is an open subset of every metric space, and every metric space is an open subset of itself. So have a nice day.